Hi, I'm Jeff Scudder, and I'll be talking with you today about getting started with the Python library for Google Data APIs. The first thing we're going to need to do is make sure that Python is available on your system. Let's get started. Now, in many operating systems, Python is already installed by default. To see if Python is available, bring up a terminal or command prompt and type Python-V to see which version you're running. If you're on Mac or Linux, this is probably already available, but on a Windows system, you'll need to install Python yourself. To install Python, begin by downloading from python.org. You can find the correct installer for your version. Once this is downloaded, you can install as you would any other Windows program. I recommend downloading Python 2.5, the latest version. Anything that's version 2.2 or later will work with the Python library, but 2.5 is easier to set up. Once you've installed Python, we need to make sure that it will run in the command line. To do this, we need to edit the Windows execution path. You can edit the execution path under the system settings. So we'll go to Control Panel, System, go to Advanced, click on Environment Variables, and find Path under System Variables. Click the Edit button to modify it. At the end of the path, we need to add the location where we've just installed Python. Once you're done, click OK. And OK again. And OK one last time. Now you should be able to run Python to see which version you have on the command line. Now that we can run Python on the command line, we need to make sure that the dependencies that the Python library needs are available on the system. The main dependency that the Python client library needs is element tree, which is used for parsing XML. If you have Python version 2.5 or higher, element tree is already available on the system. But if you're using an older version like 2.4 or 2.2, you'll need to install element tree yourself. You can download the element tree library on fbot.org. To install element tree, begin by downloading the version that's appropriate for your system. I chose to download the zip file, which I'll unarchive and install on the command line. Now that we've downloaded an unpacked element tree, we're ready to install. To install the element tree library, go to the unzip directory and install using python setup.py install. Now that element tree is installed, you can optionally install cElement tree, which is a faster version of element tree. The installation process for cElement tree is the same as I've just shown for element tree, where you use python setup.py install. Now that we know that element tree is installed on our system, we're ready to download and install the Python library. From the project's homepage, which is at code.google.com/p/gdata-python-client, you can find the latest download. Download the zip file and unpack it. Once you've unpacked this download, we can install it using a setup script as we did earlier. Simply type python setup.py install to run the installer. Now that we've installed the library, we can make sure that it's working by running some of the unit tests that are bundled with it. Go into the tests directory. Run data tests is a suite that should execute quickly. So type python run data tests to run the test script. If all the tests pass, then you can be sure that you've installed the library correctly. Now that we've installed the library, let's get a general idea for how it's structured. You can browse the source code here on code.google.com on the project site, gdata-python-client. You can see here that the source code is divided up between Adam and GData. GData contains modules for parsing XML and for making HTTP requests to Google servers. There are two types of modules in general. In each of the product-specific directories, you'll find a module that's responsible for parsing XML and one that's responsible for talking to the services. You can browse the source code as well. There's also auto-generated documentation available online, which you can find from the project homepage. If we wanted to, for example, take a look at the different data model classes that are available for Blogger, you could view this auto-generated documentation. You can see here that we have things like blog feeds and comment feeds. If you wanted to take a look at the service module, which shows the HTTP requests that can be made, you would click on Blogger Service, take a look at some of the different methods. For example, Blogger Service has methods that help you add comments, add posts, delete comments, etc. Now let's get an idea for how to use the library by looking at an interactive sample. I'm going to start by reading the titles from the Google Data APIs blog, and then show how you can post a new blog post to one of your blogs. From the command line, we'll begin by running the Python interpreter. The first thing we'll need to import is the module for Blogger. We'll also import the Atom module, which will help us construct the elements that we're sending to the Blogger service. Now we'll need to create a client which is responsible for talking to the Google servers. Now that we have our client, we can use our username and password to authenticate with Google servers to make sure that we have permission to post our new blog post later on. Now that we have our client, we're ready to get the feed of blog posts from the Google Data APIs blog. We'll paste in the URL of the blog feed. And now we should have our feed object. You can see that the feed contains multiple entries. We get 25 entries by default, and we can print out the titles of each entry as follows. You can see that we've printed the title of the 25 most recent posts to the Google Data APIs blog. Now let's show adding a new post to our blog. I have a test blog here that I'd like to add a new post to. To begin, I'll construct a new Atom entry. And I'll give it a title. I'll also give it some content. Now that we have our entry, we're ready to post it to the blog. We'll tell our client to perform a post, sending our entry to the blog's feed URL. Now we have our new entry. We can see the ID of the new blog post, and we can also see that our blog post is now on the blog. Now that we've seen this simple example with Blogger, let's take a look at where you can find more resources to use other Google Data services. There's a list of supported services on the project homepage. Each of these lists a detailed step-by-step documentation for using the various Google Data services. For example, to show more of the things that you could do with the Blogger API in the Python library, take a look at the Python Developer's Guide on code.google.com. The Google Data Python Client Library is also an open source project with an active developer community. If you find a bug or have suggestions or ideas to improve the library, feel free to post on our discussion group. So that's it. Thanks for watching and happy coding.